Students, this is Mr. Nagesh R. Tambake, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss unconventional machining process part 4. In this particular machining process, we are going to study a ultrasonic machining process. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to understand process of ultrasonic machining process. In this particular session, we are going to discuss ultrasonic machining. What is ultrasonic machining? Its major component, working principle, advantages, disadvantages, and applications. What is ultrasonic machining process? Ultrasonic machining is the removal of hard and brittle materials using an axially oscillating tool at ultrasonic frequencies. That is between 18 to 20 kilohertz. During that oscillations, the abrasive slurry of silicon carbide is continuously fed into the machining zone between a soft tool, that is tool is made up of brass or steel, and the workpiece. The abrasive particles are therefore hammered into the workpiece surface and cause chipping of fine particles from it. Therefore, the machining is occurred. Now, the oscillating tool at amplitudes ranging from 10 to 40 micrometer imposes a static pressure on the abrasive grains and feeds down as the material is removed to form the required tool shape. Now here we'll see some of the major components of USM. This is the schematic figure here we have shown in this particular presentation. Now first one is power source. This is the power source. Now here we can see this machining process requires high frequency ultrasonic wave. So as high frequency, high voltage power supply required for this process. This unit converts low frequency electric voltage, that is 60 Hz to 20 kHz high frequency electric voltage. Next one is magneto-restrictive transducer. Here there is a transducer. This transducer is a device which converts electrical signal into mechanical vibration. Here for 20,000 per second vibrations are converted. In ultrasonic machining, magnetostrictive type transducer is used to generate mechanical vibration. This transducer is made by nickel or nickel alloy. Booster. There is a booster. Now the mechanical vibration generated by transducer is passes through booster, which amplify it and supply to the horn. Tool. This is the tool. The tool used in ultrasonic machining should be such that indentation by abrasive particle does not lead to brittle fracture of it. Thus, the tool is made by tough, strong, and ductile materials like steel, stainless steel, etc. Tool holder or horn. As the name implies, the unit connects the tool to the transducer. It transfers amplified vibration from booster to the tool. It should have high endurance limit. Abrasive slurry. This is the abrasive slurry that we are using, that is going to mix with the water. A water-based slurry of abrasive particle used as abrasive slurry. In ultrasonic machining, silicon carbide, aluminum oxide, boron chloride are used as abrasive particles in this slurry. A slurry delivery and return mechanism is also used in ultrasonic machining. Now we'll see working principle of this ultrasonic machining process. Now think on which basis this particular principle is based. First, The low frequency electric current passes through electric supply. This low frequency current converts into high frequency current through some electrical equipment. This high frequency current passes through transducer. The transducer converts this high frequency electrical signal into high frequency mechanical vibration. This mechanical vibration passes through booster. The booster amplifies this high frequency vibration and send to horn. Horn, which is also known as a tool holder, transfer this amplified vibration to tool, which makes tool vibrate at ultrasonic frequency. As the tool vibrates, it makes abrasive particle to vibrate. At this high frequency, this abrasive particle strikes to the workpiece and removes metal from it. Certain advantages are there. Hard materials can be easily machined by this method. No heat generated in work, so there is no problem of work hardening or change in structure of workpiece. Non-conductive metals or non-metals which cannot be machined by ECM or EDM can be machined by this process. It does not form chip of significant size. Certain limitations are there. It is quite slower than other mechanical process. Tool wear is high because abrasive particle affect both workpiece and tool. Tool wear it is high because as we are delivering a abrasive slurry from this particular process, then abrasive particles are going to act on the tool also. Therefore, tool wear can be occur. It can machine only hard material. Ductile metal cannot be machined by this method. It cannot used to drill deep hole because it is having some limitations. Whenever we are drilling a hole, at certain depth we can drill a hole, but deep drilling is not possible with the help of this particular process. Now certain applications are there. Cutting off parts made from semiconductors at high removal rates compared to conventional machining methods. Engraving on glass as well as hardened steel and sintered carbide, like harder material, we can machine in this particular process. Parting and machining of precious stones include diamond. So whichever is the harder materials are there, that we can part off, that we can machine in the required shapes. Now, for further reading, I can recommend the book of Workshop Technology, Volume 2 by Raghuvanshi, and the second book is Production Technology by P.C. Sharma, that is also called as a HMT handbook. I hope from this particular process you have understood the ultrasonic machining process. Once again, I will repeat how this particular process is going to occur. Initially, what we are doing here, with the help of magneto restrictor, we are forcing the water with very high pressure with the abrasive, and these abrasive and water are mixed together and that are forming the slurry, and this slurry we are passing from the nozzle with high pressure, and due to this high pressure the machining can be occur, and in this, by this process we can machine very hard objects. That is the advantage of this particular process. Thank you.